Hello everyone, this is Dilip. In the last video, we have seen logical storage of the database. In this video, let's look at physical storage of the database and how we can connect the logical and physical storage views. So let's get on to the slides. So this video, I'll talk only on Oracle DB, but this is applicable to other databases as well. But for some open source databases, this may not be applicable. So physical storage. So everything we see in our computer, it's a file. So the file can be a text file, audio file, or a video file. So similarly, for a database, you will have these three kinds of basic files. Like there will be other files also, but these are the basic files necessary for database to function. So the so these will be in some format which the Oracle, what all the Oracle instances that it can understand. So let's not go into much details. So I'll look at it from the architecture point of view. So data files. So when you hear the term data files, this is where the actual data is stored. So all the tables, indexes, they are stored here. So all our data resides in data files. The next is the control files. So this is where we store the metadata of the database. So means which data file contains what. So this all coordination of the full database, like how many PDBs are there. So again, what are their contents? So the contents won't be there, but it will point to the contents. So all data files are pointed by the control files. So when we start the database on the Oracle instance, we look at control files and then proceed how to use the data files. The next one is the online redo log files. So this is where we store the commit information. So this is used for instance recovery or failover. I'll give some simple example. Say you have done some insert or delete statement you have used in the for a table. So that information, once you run the commit, so as you know, like if you don't run commit, that the transaction won't be complete. So once you run the commit, so this insert statement you have run or update statement you have run for the table, so it will be stored in the redo log file immediately. So that way, even though writing to the disk may take some time, but first it will be recorded in the redo log files. So in case if some power outage or something happens, for the instance recovery, this will be helpful. Okay, so failover, anyway, like we'll discuss more about it later. So this is how the physical storage looks like. If you go into the more minute detail, so how any files are stored. So if you take any text file or audio or video file, they are stored in multiples of OS data block. So it is underlying file system specific, how much at each data block is. So if you take any file, it will be a multiple of that OS data block. So for example, for the NTFS file system, block size is 4 KB. So any file is a multiple of this 4 KB. So this is the OS data block. And then there is a Oracle database data block also. So this data block is different from the underlying operating system data block. So this data block, it's a multiple of underlying file system data block. And Oracle, when it deals with the storage, it will deal in terms of its own data block size. It doesn't rely on file system data block size. All other applications or any software you take, they will do it in terms of OS data block size. But Oracle, it does it in terms of its own predefined data block size, which can be modified as well. So this is necessary for the storage as well as performance reasons. And these four terms, whatever you see here, these are also called logical storage from the code point of view. So if we are going into the Oracle instance and how it is written. So there we actually look at it from the point of view of these terms. So for us, we don't say it's a table, we say it's a segment, okay? And we have a table space there as well, just like the normal logical view. So next, there is an extent also. So set of logically contiguous data blocks, you call it an extent, okay? So these are restricted to a single data file. So extents can be spanned across multiple data files. Now, segment. So we don't call anything table. We call it segment in the Oracle instance point of view when we do the coding and all. So segment means, in essence, a table can be called a segment. An index can be called a segment. So there are like other things also which you can call as a segment. Okay. Only thing is segment is like say a set of one data entry, like which can be viewed from the logical point of view. So it can be a table or index or other similar things. Now, set of extents make a segment. Okay. Now, set of one or more segments, they make the table space. So this is the logical storage from the Oracle code point of view. So physical and logical storage. Now, if we combine whatever I told about physical and logical files, like logical storage views, it will look like this. So the most basic is a OS block. And Oracle Database is a multiple of OS blocks. That's why there is a many-to-one relationship. Again, an extent is a set of Oracle data blocks. A segment is a set of extents. Table space is a set of segments. So segment means you can just put table here. Okay. A table space, it can span across multiple data files. So that's why you can see there is a many to one between data file and table space. And again, basically any data file or any file in the OS, it's a multiple of OS block size. And extents. So multiple extents. This indicates this does, it's not like these extents form the data file, but many extents can be there. And one extent is restricted to single data file. So you cannot have two extents spreading across multiple data files. Okay. But a segment can spread across multiple data files. So this is what I'm talking about. Say a segment can span across multiple data files. So here there are two data files you can see, and a table is spread across these two data files. And if you see a table space, it's a one or more data files. Okay, so they form the table space. And here you can see segments indicating like a table or index can be called a segment. So this one represents a data file. So yeah, so this is what physical and logical storage of the database. So next we will look at some more architectural views of the Oracle database. So thanks everyone for watching the video. Please like, share, and subscribe. Thank you.